Hello and a very happy good morning to all my 11th class students. I am Preeti Gupta and today I am going to teach you another topic of your unit number 1. The topic is supplementary units and some physical quantities. So in the previous class students, we discussed the unit. You all know that units are very much important, in which we have discussed the fundamental and derived units, right? In the fundamentals unit, we have seven base units are there, all right? That is length, mass, time, electric current, luminous intensity, amount of a substance, and thermodynamic temperature. Okay, by this we can derive the units like area, volume, density, all right? So today in this class I'm going to discuss the supplementary units. So students, if I talk about the definition of a supplementary unit, so supplementary unit, basically they are the dimensionless units, right? Because they are employed with the fundamental units. Okay, we can say the base units, they are employed with the fundamental unit to create the derived unit. Okay, now we are going to discuss here that if we attach these type of units with the fundamental units, we can easily derive the derived units, to create the derived unit. So let's start, students. Supplementary units, basically I'll talk there ki it is a dimensionless and it is attached with the, it is employed with the fundamental unit to create the derived units. Basically, the supplementary units are utilized in two major variables, students, such as phase angle and solid angles. Okay, we discussed these phase angles and solid angles in the next class. Okay, so supplementary units, basically this class of unit was created in 1960 to cover those units which are neither base units nor derived from base units, basically. Now the next topic is prefixes. Some physical quantities, like we'll talk about mass, we'll talk about weight, volume, temperature, these all are physical quantities, right? Are either maybe too small, or we can say it's too large. To change the order of magnitude, these are expressed by using prefixes before the name of the base units. We learned the base unit in the fundamental unit, students. All right, if we measure the length of a pen or a table in meter, if I put a length in the centimeter, so what is centi? Centi is the prefix we used. Okay, before the base unit. So here it is the same table which I drawn in this particular book. It is already drawn in your NCRT book. Just go through your NCRT. So here you can see that prefixes used in SI system. SI, you can see that it is a very important system. So here the six columns are there: multiple, prefix, and symbol. Students, अभी इसकी वैल्यू आपको पता नहीं पड़ेगी. When you go further in the next unit, that is known as the structure of atom, then equilibrium, then thermodynamics, you know the value of this unit. Basically, the word says some basic concepts of chemistry. So this unit is very, very useful in your class 12th also. So here you can see multiple, prefix, and symbol. Multiple, prefix, and symbol. Just I'm going to take one by one. 10 raised to the power minus 1, prefix is used deci, and symbol is used as small d. 10 raised to the power minus 2, centi, small c. 10 raised to the power minus 3, milli, small m. 10 raised to the power minus 6, micro, mu. Okay, 10 raised to the power minus 9, nano, n. 10 raised to the power minus 12, pico, small p. Alright, 10 raised to the power minus 15, femto, 10 raised to the power minus 18, atto, 10 raised to the power minus 21, zepto, and 10 raised to the power minus 24, yocto, denoted by small y. Same here, okay, 10 raised to the power 1, deca, 10 raised to the power 2, hecto, denoted by small h, 10 raised to the power 3, kilo, capital K, 10 raised to the power 6, mega, capital M, 10 raised to the power 9, giga, capital G, 10 raised to the power 12, tetra, capital T, 10 raised to the power 15, peta, capital P, 10 raised to the power 18, exa, capital E, 10 raised to the power 21, zeta, capital Z, 10 raised to the power 24, iota, capital Y. So these are the prefixes which are used before the name of the base unit. Here you can see this whole table is already made in your NCERT book. Just go with your NCERT. To better understand this prefixes and how the conversion is to be done, so let's take an example in the form of a question. Students, the question is the convert the following into basic units, right? So we have learned about the basic units, like we have to convert them into the base units, or we can say in the fundamental units, right? Here you can see I have write the first is 28.7 picometers. Okay, all right students, so we have already learned that 1 pico is equals to 10 raised to the power minus 12. So I am going to write it here that 1 picometer is meter is equals to 10 raised to the power minus 12 meter. All right, and then in 28.7 picometer contains how much meter? This multiply by this and divide by this, so we can get that 28.7 picometer into 10 raised to the power minus 12 meter divided by 1 picometer. Hence, from the numerator and denominator are same, then picometer and picometer has been cut it out, and the remaining is the answer, that 28.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 12 meter. So it now it gets converted into meters. Here you can see that the prefix has been changed into the base units. So it is very important, student, we must change whatever the in the question is giving to us, we must change that particular unit into the SI unit. All right, so here picometer changes into the meter. All right, now student, second is example is very important, just take a look on this. All right, so here I'm going to take that 15.15 microseconds. All right, in 1 micro, just remember in the table, 1 micro is equals to 10 raised to the power minus 6. All right, so here I can write it here that 1 microsecond is equals to 10 raised to the power minus 6 seconds. All right, and now in 15.15 microsecond, that same this multiply by this and divide by this, so here I can write it here that 15.15 microsecond into 10 raised to the power minus 6 second divided by 1 microsecond. Here also numerator and denominators are same, then it will cut it down. So what remains? 15.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 second. अब आप क्या कर सकते हो, इसको और चेंज कर सकते हो. अगर मुझे मान लीजिए कि एक ही डेसिमल से पहले मेरे पास एक डिजिट होनी चाहिए, तो ये मैथमेटिक्स में भी करते हैं कि डेसिमल को कैसे कन्वर्ट किया जाता है, राइट? अब देखिए, अगर मैं यहाँ पर इसको खोलती हूँ, अगर मैं यहाँ से इस साइन को हटाती हूँ, इस डेसिमल को हटाती हूँ, तो वॉट आई गेट 15.15 नीचे आ जाएगा 10 raised to the power 2 इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर, राइट? एंड 10 raised to the power 6 रिमेन सेम. ऑल राइट, अगर मुझे डेसिमल केवल एक डिजिट के बाद पुट करना है, इसका मतलब मुझे इन तीन से पहले डेसिमल लगाना पड़ेगा. अगर मैं 10 raised to the power 2 करती हूँ, तो ऑब्वियसली बात है वापस यहीं आ जाऊँगी. तो क्यों ना मैं ऊपर नीचे बोथ इन द न्यूमरेटर साइड एंड द डिनोमिनेटर साइड आई हैव टू डिवाइड विद 10 एंड मल्टीप्लाई with 10. So here I am going to multiply with 10 and divide by 10. So you can easily see in this transformation that here you get 10 raised to the power 3. All right, so अब क्या होगा, अगर 10 raised to the power 3 हो गया, तो तीन डिजिट से पहले यहाँ पर क्या लग जाएगा, डेसिमल लग जाएगा. तो अगर मैं इसको कन्वर्ट करूँगी, तो ये कन्वर्ट हो गया 1.515 में, और यहाँ मेरे पास रह गया, क्योंकि यहाँ पर 10 raised to the power यहाँ पर बच रहा है माइनस 6 प्लस 1. ओके, सो मेरे पास यहाँ पर क्या रह गया, 1.515 इंटू 10 डेज टू द पावर माइनस 5 सेकेंड. हेयर आई गेट दैट 15.15 माइक्रो सेकेंड इज नाउ गेट कन्वर्टेड इंटू सेकेंड, एंड इट्स अ वेरी ईजी मैथड एंड इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मैथड टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो हेयर आई गेट द आंसर इज 1.515 इंटू 10 डेज टू द पावर माइनस 5 सेकेंड. स्टूडेंट्स, now students, some physical quantities are next topic. First I'm going to discuss here mass and weight. Basically in chemistry there is no difference in mass and weight, the difference is taken in physics only. All right, so basic we have to learn the physical quantities. So just start mass and weight. Student, mass is denoted by small m, it is the amount of matter in a substance. ओके, इट रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट. इट्स एसआई यूनिट इज किलोग्राम. एंड वॉट इज वेट नाउ? वेट इज डिनोटेड बाय कैपिटल डब्ल्यू. ठीक है, इट इज द फोर्स एग्जर्टेड बाय ग्रेविटी ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट. बिकॉज इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द ग्रेविटी, सो इट चेंजेस, या और वी कैन से इट वेरीज फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस ड्यू टू चेंज इन ग्रेविटी. इट वेरीज फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस ड्यू टू चेंज इन ग्रेविटी. इट्स यूनिट इज न्यूटन. नेक्स्ट, वॉल्यूम. वॉल्यूम द स्पेस ऑक्यूपाइड बाय मैटर. द स्पेस ऑक्यूपाइड बाय मैटर इज नोन एज वॉल्यूम. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द डिराइव्ड यूनिट्स, वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड इन द डिराइव्ड यूनिट्स, द एसआई यूनिट ऑफ वॉल्यूम इज मीटर क्यूब. ऑल राइट, नाउ द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस आर वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट 1 लीटर इज इक्वल्स टू 1000 ml. वी ऑलरेडी लर्न दिस थिंग्स इन द जूनियर क्लासेज, राइट? 1 लीटर इज इक्वल्स टू 1000 ml, विच इज इक्वल्स टू 1000 cm³, एंड विच इज नाउ इक्वल टू 1 dm³. सो 1 dm³ इज इक्वल्स टू 1000 cm³, और वी कैन से 1000 ml, और वी कैन से 1 लीटर. नाउ 1 m³ इज इक्वल्स टू 100 cm³. सेम हेयर इज इक्वल्स टू 10^10. अगर हम इसे ओपन करेंगे तो हमें क्या मिलेगा? 10^6 cm³, विच इज इक्वल टू 10^3 dm³, और वी कैन से 10^3 liters. सो दीज आर द फिजिकल क्वान्टिटी स्टूडेंट. नेक्स्ट इज डेंसिटी. इट इज डिफाइंड एज द अमाउंट और मास पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम. वी ऑल नो दैट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डेंसिटी इज इक्वल्स टू मास अपॉन वॉल्यूम. सो द यूनिट बिकम्स मास. द एसआई यूनिट ऑफ मास इज किलोग्राम, एंड वॉल्यूम एसआई यूनिट इज मीटर क्यूब. सो इफ यू राइट द यूनिट, यू गेट द यूनिट इज किलोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब और ग्राम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. सो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डेंसिटी इज मास पर वॉल्यूम. नेक्स्ट, फिजिकल क्वांटिटी इज टेम्परेचर. स्टूडेंट्स, टेम्परेचर इज द डिग्री ऑफ हॉटनेस और कोल्डनेस. 3 scales आर देयर. फर्स्ट इज डिग्री सेल्सियस, सेकेंड इज केल्विन, एंड थर्ड वन इज द डिग्री फेरेनहाइट. वी यूज द केल्विन स्केल एज द एसआई यूनिट. सो इन द केल्विन स्केल, द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर इज 273.15 केल्विन. यू कैन सी हियर, in the Kelvin scale, freezing point of water is 273.15 kelvin, and the boiling point of water is 373.15 kelvin. You all know these terms, so there is a difference of 100. Okay, now in the Celsius scale, freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius, and the boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. Here you can see the difference 100. Now, what is the relationship between Kelvin and degree Celsius scale? Just remember these formulas. You have learned these formula in your junior classes. So, okay, now we must convert the temperature which is giving to us in a degree Celsius or Fahrenheit into the Kelvin. Because why SI unit is Kelvin is taken only? Because its value is never be negative. So that's why it is taken as a SI unit, students. So here you can see the relationship between degree Celsius and Kelvin. Degree Celsius equals to Kelvin minus 273.15. You can skip this one point, 0.15. All right, you can just take only 273 to do your calculations easier. So when we'll take the degree Celsius there, that when we'll take this minus 273.15 at that side, then it converts into the positive sign. So what we get, K is equals to degree Celsius plus 273.15. So these are the relationships. Now one more relationship is there, that the relationship between degree Celsius and degree Fahrenheit scale, students. So relationship is degree Celsius is equals to 5/9 degree Fahrenheit minus 32. Or if we turn these degree Fahrenheit here, degree Fahrenheit is equals to 9/5 degree Celsius plus 32. So these are the relationship between, basically these are the transformation. You can easily transform degree Celsius into Kelvin, or all right, and if you find out the Kelvin, you can easily change degree Celsius into Kelvin, or you can change easily Fahrenheit to Celsius and Celsius to Fahrenheit. So these are some relationships. Now to better understand, I'm going to take an example. So the question is, convert them. Now I am going to convert these temperatures into the given temperature. First I am going to take that as 20 degree Celsius into Kelvin. Alright, so what is the relationship between Kelvin? What is the relation? If we find out the Kelvin, then Kelvin comes here. The Kelvin is equals to degree Celsius plus 273.15. Okay, now the value of degree Celsius is 20 degree Celsius. So can I put this value at this place, at the place of degree Celsius? What I get, that 20 plus 273.15. Once I calculate this value, the what I get, 293.15 in Kelvin. So this 20 degree Celsius is now changes into 293.15 Kelvin. So I am going to write the answer over here, 293.15 Kelvin. All right. Now second question is, just turn, just transform, just convert 20 degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit. So what is the formula of degree Fahrenheit? Degree Fahrenheit is equals to 9/5 degree Celsius plus 32. So at this place of degree Celsius, can I write 20? So what I get, 9/5 20 plus 32. Okay, now if we 5 ki table mein 20 aata hai, agar main ise cut karungi to kitni bar jayega, 4 times. So it cut and 4 times, 9 4s are 36, 36 plus 32, what I get, 68. So it converts into 68 degree Fahrenheit. So answer is 68 degree Fahrenheit. So students, in today's video we have discussed the supplementary unit. In this we have discussed the prefixes also, and we discussed some physical quantities. All right. So now the next is, now the last and the next is, all right students. So this is all about today's class. Basically length is also there, so we can easily calculate the length in meter. This is the last important physical quantity, so just take a look. Last physical quantity, that is length, its SI unit is meter. We have already discussed, it is expressed in angstrom. Remember, it is expressed in angstrom, or we can say nanometer, or we can say picometer. So 1 angstrom is equals to 10 raised to the power minus 10 meter. We can change into centimeter also. Once get converted into meter, then this meters now get converted into centimeter. So these are the conversions. Okay, 1 nanometer is equals to 10 raised to the power 9 meter, and 1 picometer is equals to 10 raised to the power minus 12 meter. So now students, this is all about in today class. In the next class we are going to discuss the scientific notations, accuracy and precision. Thank you so much.